Good morning, class 10. So we were in chapter number 9, application of trigonometry. Okay. So here are certain questions of the exercises that we'll be discussing today. Question number 4 of NCERT exercise 9. The angle of elevation of the top of a tower from a point on the ground which is 30 meters away from the foot of the tower. Means the point from where the observer is looking at the top of the tower, that point is 30 meters away from the foot of the tower, and the angle of elevation is found to be 30 degrees. So we have to find the height of the tower. See children, according to the question, if you can form the diagram, your question is half done. Aadhi problem solve hai yadi aap diagram bana lete. Let us assume this as a tower. This is the ground. Simple. AB is the tower. At point C, this point C is 30 meters from the foot of the tower. The angle of elevation of the top of the tower is found to be 30 degrees. We have to find the height of the tower. This is the tower, this is the ground. On the ground, the point C, from where the observer is looking at the top of the tower, that point is 30 meters away from the foot. Foot of the tower is B. The top is point A. The angle of elevation is 30 degrees. We have to find height of the tower. So for this angle theta, this is perpendicular and this is base. You can relate perpendicular and base by using tan theta or cot theta. So in this triangle ABC, tan 30 degrees is equal to perpendicular H upon base 30. Tan 30 is 1 upon under root 3 equal to H upon 30. Cross multiply, H equal to 30 upon under root 3. See, denominator cannot be left irrational, we have to rationalize it. So this multiply numerator and denominator by under root 3. 30 under root 3 upon 3, which is 10 under root 3 meters. So the height of the tower is 10 under root 3 meters. It may also happen in the question you can be provided by, suppose it is given, use under root 3 equal to 1.73. If this is given, you have to use it. So it will be 10 into 1.73, which is 17.3 meters. This is the height of the tower. I hope you got this solution. Let's move to next question. Question number 6. A 1.5 meter tall person, the boy, is standing at some distance, we don't know that distance, from a 30 meter tall building. There is a building, it is 30 meters tall. From that building, at some distance, there is a boy whose height is 1.5 meter tall. And the angle of elevation from his eye to the top of the tower, top of the building, from his eye, the angle of elevation of the top of the building increases from 30 degrees to 60 degrees. Suppose, let us assume that you are standing somewhere and you are looking at a building. The angle of elevation of the top of the building is found to be 30 degrees. As you move closer to the building, the angle of elevation increases. So what is happening, 1.5 meter tall boy looking at the top of a 30 meter tall building, standing at some distance from the building. As he moves towards the building, the angle of inclination increases from 30 degrees to 60 degrees. We have to find the distance that he has walked towards the building. So let's say this is the building on the ground. Here is 1.5 meter tall boy. His height is 1.5 meters. So I draw a parallel line, parallel to the ground, horizontal line. The entire building is of 30 meters. So this height will be 1.5 and this will be 28.5. Understood? Total height of the building is 30 meters. Height of this person is 1.5. So from his eye, if I take horizontal line from his eye, the line of sight. So this point, it is 1.5 meters. Total building is 30. So the remaining part is 28.5. Now from here, the angle of elevation of the top is how much? 30 degrees. Now this fellow moves towards the building. Suppose he comes here, he reaches here. Now at this point, the angle of inclination or elevation is found to be 60 degrees. So this is the distance he has traveled. Let us take this distance as x. This remaining distance is y. Understood? So we have two angles, so we can consider two triangles because we have two unknown quantities. Though we have to find only y, only x, but x alone cannot be found without the help of y. Okay? So बहुत simple सा fundamental है. अगर दो angles हैं, दो right triangles form हो रहे हैं, तो आपको दो equations बनाने हैं. This is point A, this is B, this is C, this is D. Okay? Now first, in triangle ABC, angle is 60. So if this is y, this distance is also y, this is x, this is also x. Tan 60 degrees is equal to perpendicular 28.5 upon base. Base is y. What is tan 60? Under root 3 equal to 28.5 upon y. We need the value of y. So y equal to 28.5 upon under root 3. This is the value of y. Consider it as equation number 1. We don't want y, but we will use y to find the value of x. Now for this angle, this is perpendicular to triangle ABD. In triangle ABD, angle is 30. So tan 30 degrees is equal to perpendicular 28.5 upon base. Base is the entire x plus y. Tan 30 degrees 1 upon under root 3 equal to 28.5 upon x plus y. Cross multiply x plus y equal to 28.5 multiplied by under root 3. We want x. So x is equal to 28.5 into under root 3 minus y. This y goes to the other side. Y, what is the value of y? 28.5 upon under root 3. Let's take under root 3 as LCM. So this becomes under root 3 into under root 3, 3. 3 times 28.5 minus 28.5 whole upon under root 3. So 3 times 28.5 taken common. 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 into 28.5 is 57. Upon under root 3, which becomes 19 under root 3. See, 57 is 19 into 3. So 3 divided by under root 3 becomes under root 3. So 19 under root 3 meter. This is the distance which the boy has walked towards the building. So this x, the value of x is 19 under root 3 meters. So children, always see how many angles you are having and how many triangles you can frame, how many unknown quantities you have. Very simple. Jitni angles honge, utne triangles honge, aapke paas utni hi unknown quantities hongi. Usi ke according aapko solve karna hai, right? Let's move on to another question. Okay, next question is, the question says, from the top of a 7 meter high building, the angle of elevation of the top of a tower is 60 degree and the angle of depression of its foot is found to be 45 degrees. We have to find the height of the tower. So tower is taller than the building because from the top of the building, we are looking at the top of the tower and angle of elevation is formed. So obviously tower is higher than the building. So let us take this as the ground. Here is 7 meter high building and here is the tower. Let us say AB is the building, CD is the tower. This is given as 7 meters. So this is the horizontal. Let us consider this point as E. Now from this point, the angle of inclination of the top is found to be 60 degrees from the top of the building. Now from the same point, the angle of depression of the foot of the tower is found to be 45 degrees. So angle of depression is always measured with respect to the horizontal. So this angle is 45. If this is 45, this becomes 45 because lines are parallel, alternate interior angles. So we have to find the entire height of the tower, right? So this is 7, so this will also be 7. I will consider it as small h and this distance as x. So we are having two triangles, one with angle 45 degrees, another right angle triangle with angle 60 degrees, okay? You can use triangle ADE or you can use triangle ABD, whatever it is. So in triangle ABD, tan 45 degrees is equal to perpendicular 7 upon base x. Tan 45 is 1 equal to 7 upon x. So x equal to 7. We got the value of x as 7 meters. Now we will use x to find the value of h. So if this is x, this is also x. Now in triangle ACE, angle is 60 degrees. Tan 60 degrees is equal to perpendicular small h upon base. Base is x. What is the value of x? 7. Clear? So tan 60 is under root 3 equal to h upon 7. H is equal to 7 under root 3. You got the value of h as 7 under root 3 meters. This is not the entire height of the tower. Entire height of the tower, capital H, is h plus 7. So height of the tower h is equal to h plus 7, that is 7 under root 3 plus 7. 7 taken common, under root 3 plus 1. Now in the question, if it says use under root 3 equal to 1.73, so this value will become 7 multiplied by 1.73 plus 1, 2.73. 19.11 meters. So this is how, children, we will be solving the questions of this exercise. Try to solve the questions and come up with the doubts. Practice as many questions as you can. Tomorrow in the next class, we will try to solve some more questions. Some questions which are more, you say, difficult or complicated ones, we will try to solve them.